Member Rauf Khawgeem.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Mr. Speaker, intellectuals entering politics is very hazardous sometimes, but their contribution in assemblies such as this is something that all of us appreciate. Most of them, though they belong to some party or the other, their observations most of the time are bereft of politics. They speak of the ideal political utopian systems. Professor Viswavarnapala was a towering intellectual who entered this house way back in 1994. I had the privilege of entering politics or entering this parliament in the same year, and we all benefited from such personalities who were professors. We had Professor A.V. Suravira along with Vishwa, and also Professor G.L. Pieris. Their contribution in the House, in every debate, if you can go back to the Hansard and look at what they have said, we will find that it is very worthy of reading. This is what my learned friend Bandula spoke a while ago. Let me also give him my advance wishes for getting his doctorate in a month's time. We are adding to the long list of intellectuals in the House another learned colleague, Bandula Gunawadana, who himself has a string of students whom he have coached and taught economics in the country. So we are benefited by the contributions of all these people. But Professor Viswavarnapala was a multifaceted individual. He simply didn't stick to his own political ideology. He studied the way in which left politics impacted in the social reformation of our country and its national politics. We know during the imperialist times, it was the labor movement that was virtually turned into political parties. Then after independence, we had the birth of Mahajana Eksat Peramuna originally, and thereafter the Sri Lanka Freedom Party. Professor Viswavarnapala, everybody knew as a dedicated party man. Having entered the Sri Lanka Freedom Party in the mid-1960s, he had been a faithful of the party, who had gone through all the ups and downs of the party's fortunes in the national politics. But he had the good fortune of entering parliament in 1994, when President Chandrika Bandaranaike Kumarathunga recognized his contribution both to the intellectual domain of this country as well as to the party itself, and appointed him to the national list. We have several of them who have written many books and manuals and articles, but then when you look at Vishwa's contribution, I don't think anybody else could claim that they are as better or much better than he is, because he has written in such different multifaceted areas. Particularly, I observed his contribution in the Public Accounts Committee of this Parliament. As a member and chairman of the Public Accounts Committee, he was somebody who had studied very deeply the oversight functions of Parliament and the need to improve the parliamentary oversight of public finance. He, in fact, I think, I believe he even wrote a book on the role of Public Accounts Committee of Parliament and how things should be introduced to improve its oversight functions. He also looked at the civil service in the country. He had written books on the improvement of civil service and its contribution to the administration of the country. He contrasted our civil administration with that of the civil service during the imperialist times. He looked at it with the from a regional perspective and contrasted it with civil service in the rest of the regions. So we had a almost a bird's eye view of every subject when you read his writings, his books, and his researchers. So we have, in fact, in losing Professor Viswavarnapala, a big void in this house. But his knowledge was such that he dealt with even personalities. I remember he once wrote about Dr. N.M. Pereira, the towering left politicians this country had produced. And his personality was studied in depth. So he also looked at certain other revolutionary leaders. His contribution in looking at Udakandavala Sri Saranankara, an assessment of his role in anti-imperialist struggle in Sri Lanka, looking at the imperialist struggle and the contribution of the Buddhist clergy in the country in order to raise the nationalist awareness. So being part of the left of center politics, he looked at every different angle in which this country came to be impacted by during different times, during the colonial times, during the post-independence period, and thereafter, the way in which the different administrations embraced different ideologies. Now we talk about capitalism, socialism, neoliberalism. Now we are talking about social market economy. So this government is now talking about social market economy. These are all variations of different ideologies, but to fit the times and the needs of the country's economic policies. So people of Professor Viswavarnapala's caliber were able to critically look at both the good and the bad in the different systems and talk about the reality and the way in which the application of such ideologies impact on the social fabric and politics of the country. I believe his loss is indeed a big void that has been created, and I would, in keeping with the faith that he adhered to, wish him according to the Buddhist principles, Nivan Subha, and also convey my condolence to his family members. Thank you.